Welcome to Social Element Ministries, where we set the captives free in the name of Lord Jesus Christ. This is a short message, but not one that qualifies as a quote-unquote ministry minute. Thing is, in Titus 1:16, the Apostle Paul wrote, "They profess that they know God, but in works they deny him, being abominable and disobedient, and unto every good work reprobate." The thing is, there are many people who profess to know God, but in their actions, to include their words, they communicate that they do not know God. And for some, they actually communicate that there is no God. And a part of discerning this is how people treat children, to include the unborn. And when it comes to children, one thing to remember is what Jesus said as recorded in Mark 9:42. "And whosoever shall offend one of these little ones that believe in me, it is better for him that a millstone were hanged about his neck and he were cast into the sea." If a person has a millstone attached to their body, they're going to go down, they're going to stay down. Try swimming with an anchor and see how that works out. The Lord is saying that it would be better for a person who offends a little child to be drowned in the sea. The Lord doesn't view life as starting when a person is born. And you can tell a lot about a person and their relationship with the Lord based on how they view and treat children, to include the unborn. In Jeremiah 1:5, the Lord said to Jeremiah, "Before I formed thee in thy mother's womb." So it was the Lord who formed Jeremiah in his mother's womb. It is commensurate with how David spoke about how he was fearfully and wonderfully made. The Lord made Jeremiah. The Lord made David. The Lord made you. Bringing your parents together was a mere formality. It was the Lord who made you. So the Lord said to Jeremiah, "Before I formed thee in thy mother's belly, in thy mother's womb, I knew thee, and I ordained thee a prophet unto the nations." There are some people in the Bible where their birth was prophesied. Not only was their birth, but their name. In Genesis 18, the Lord spoke to Abraham about giving him a son whom he should call Isaac. In 1 Kings 13, a prophet from Judah prophesied about a coming king whose name was Josiah. Isaiah prophesied about a coming king, the Lord of Lords and King of Kings, who should be called Emmanuel. Emmanuel meaning God with us. In Matthew 1, we see an angel telling. In Matthew 1, we see an angel. In Luke 1, we see an angel telling Jesus' parents, his future parents, to call him Jesus. In Isaiah 44 through 45, we see Isaiah prophesying about the birth of a king whose name would be Cyrus. The Lord calls people. He knows them by name even before their birth. He has a destiny for them even before their birth. The Apostle Paul in Galatians 1 also wrote about how the Lord separated him from his mother's womb, called him as an apostle of Christ Jesus. We can tell a lot about a person's relationship based on how they view and treat children, to include the unborn. And it's about offending the little ones. There are many ways to look at the word offend. Offend causes to sin. Offend also to hurt. Offend. How do we defend the little children, especially and to include the unborn? One of the things the Lord cited in the Bible, Leviticus 18:21, was the abomination of those engaged in child sacrifice, abortion, and I'll specify non-therapeutic abortion, is a form of child sacrifice. You can tell a lot about a person's relationship based on how they view and treat children, to include the unborn. Many people are professing Jesus as Lord, but their actions are denying him. And as Jesus told many people, rightly did Isaiah prophesied, his name is on your lips, but your hearts are far from him. Oh, one more thing. Woe unto those who say they know God, but in their actions they communicate that to them there is no God.